We document MJ wanting to come back. He starts hanging out with BJ during the filming of Space Jam, starts going to practices, has those open runs on the Space Jam set.
LeBron and Space Jam 2 is not going to be as good as Jordan.
Space Jam 2 is going to be better than Space Jam.
Yeah, you think so? No, it's not, because Jordan's a corn. I mean, because LeBron is a corn.
Yeah, but
so
are we talking about like actors? Because MJ did not do a great job acting.
He was cool though. He's cool. It's cool to see. It's cool to see. Like it was cool to see Jordan. It's not cool to see Bron.
I saw Space Jam. It was on sale in Target for $5. I saw the Blu-ray, so I bought it, and I was like, "Oh, this is great!" Like I love Space Jam as a kid. Don't hit the same in your 30s. Space Jam does not hit the same in your 30s.
It's also on Netflix.
It's recently on Netflix. Why are you getting on me for buying a fucking movie? Everybody gets on me for buying movies. I like to have a movie.
Also on Netflix.
In my possession. It was $5.
Big baller. I got you. But I do not buy the Blu-rays no more because I spent all my money on these
The streaming sites? I hear you on that.
So, therefore, I'm like, yo, I spent so much money on streaming that I will not spend any more money on the Blu-rays. I should have it.
It's reasonable.
What I loved about seeing the Jordan during that time of Space Jam was his level and dedication not only to what he was doing, but to the game of basketball and focusing on his return because he was just fresh off of losing in the 95.
Yeah, against the Magic. Conference Finals. So Eastern Semis.
Yeah, Eastern Semis. So he was already focused, and he was back at it right after. Mm-hmm. And he was already focused on capitalizing. And more importantly, he's like, yo, I've been out for a minute. Let me invite
great players.
Some greats. And let me see what they're about. And let me learn their game. And like, in my head, I'm like, oh, dope. I want to go play with Jordan. And Jordan, he's like, all right, cool. So he
scouting.
Only goes right.
Scouting everybody.
Shoot, you know what I'm saying? And that's how he's breaking it down. Mm-hmm. But yet still, it was still keeping his competitive edge. And there was no offseason. There was no days off. There was no breaks. And I respect that, man. You want to be great. It costs.
You put the work in.
Put the work in.
Absolutely. You know, MJ just takes the fuel of losing in the playoffs and not being in shape, gets in incredible shape again, comes back that season, the 95-96 season, and they win 72 games. Win the most games any NBA team has ever won in a season.
Different.
He's back wearing 23. He turns up the intensity in the 1995 camp. That's where he has the fight with Steve Kerr. And gets thrown out of practice.
Yeah.
Once again, I really do feel like a lot of players just feel like it's an honor to get punched in the face by Michael Jordan.
Steve made it sound like a badge. He was like, and after that, our friendship has gotten so.
Oh, we were so tight.
Nigga, you got snuffed.
I'd have caught you in the parking lot. Right after.
Right after your Corvette and your Range Rover.
But I think, but MJ called and apologized, right? So,
big.
I mean, that kind of helps.
Big.
That helps a lot also, right?
Big.
They go into that season, like I said, 72-10. They face dominant. The Magic again. They sweep the Magic in the Eastern Conference Finals. Dominant. MJ's dominant. MJ's the MVP. And then, of course, they face, and I want to spend a little time with they face the Sonics in the 96 Finals, right? Sonics have Sean Kemp, George Carl as their coach. They got Gary Payton, who was the Defensive Player of the Year at the time. And this is, you know, MJ's first playoffs, first games he's playing without his dad in the stands. The Bulls, they go up 3-0, and it looks pretty easy. Yeah. Gary Payton goes, apparently, Gary Payton goes to George Carl and says, I can guard him.
Why are they up 3-0? Why do they dominate the Sonics in such a fashion? Oh, that's because George Carl walked past Mike.
Yes.
He walked past Mike. To start the series,
mm-hmm.
And Mike ain't like that too much.
Mike saw it as a slight. Because
we know each other, my man.
Exactly.
It's love.
We know each other. We see each other at events. We see each other on campus. We both went to North Carolina.
Right.
I mean, come on, son. You gonna ignore me?
We going to dad
in the restaurant.
Best of luck.
Ooh, nothing.
Okay. Nah, I was okay.
So you're not gonna say nothing to me.
Cool.
Okay, all right, got you. All right, got it.
So now we're up 3-0.
So now you're on your Molly shit. Gary Payton says, I can guard him. I figured it out. They go up. I mean, the Sonics do their best. They win two games. So it gets pushed to six games. And Michael Jordan is looking at the video of Gary Payton saying, I figured it out.
Yeah,
if I would have done this earlier, he was like, the glove?
I had no problem with the
glove.
I had no, take your iPad back, man. Because I had no problem with the glove.
I'm going to break this shit. I had no problem with the glove.
He was laughing.
Yeah. And then game six is on Father's Day in Chicago. MJ's because family in the
this
stands.
This is written, bro. This is written.
Do you think he lost those two games to get back to Chicago and try to win this game on Father's Day?
I don't know, man. Maybe. And if he did, so the fuck what?
I don't know. I mean,
what? Why? 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 It means more.
It's the.
It means more.
It means more. I'm a father. But it's the.
I lost my father.
It's the peak of arrogance, the literal peak, to think I'm gonna take my foot off the pedal for these last two games, and still know that I have the chance to win this either in six or in seven, or I'm gonna win this game on this day. Like, I have the power and the control to win this game on this day.
Is it arrogance or is it like, we're just, yo, you know what it is, man? So we're all normal.
You know what? I'm wrong. I fucked up. Because I'm doing the same thing again. Like, I'm doing the AC trip. I'm doing the cigars. I'm doing the alcohol. I'm applying human rules to Michael Jordan.
Yeah, you tweaking, boy. Like, I'm
saying, I'm wilding.
Like, yeah.
I'm bugging. You're right.
Boy, I control this shit.
You're right.
I want to celebrate this particular finals because I'm going to win so many.
On this day.
On this day because... You know what? My pops is not here. So you know what? If we lose two games, y'all can wait. Two more games of basketball anyway. Take it. Because you know during those times, we're like, oh, I just missed the series and go to seven.
You got
it's so good. I just wanted to go to seven. Basketball's over at the end of the series.
Now you're right.
Take two more.
You're right.
Greatness.
You're right. I was
my
wrong.
My decision.
And MJ does have that power and that ability. And then, of course, he wins the game. Like, emotional embrace.
Also, I was fighting it back a little bit.
Oh, really? It was emotional. I've seen that video a bunch of times, even as a kid. You remember seeing, like, the celebration.
I didn't know why he was doing it like that. Like, I didn't know what he endured. I didn't know that the whole streets were saying, like, yo, you're the reason.
And him and his dad were best friends.
I didn't know him and his dad were so close.
Yeah.
You feel me? So it hits different now watching it from this perspective of when, listen, I'm all in. I'm 100%. I'm Jordan out, bro. I got the leggings on today. I'm locked in, but like now I'm on board with this narrative and how this story went. So I understand.
It's so great. I can't wait until they get to that Pacers series, huh?
It's so great.
It's so great. I can't wait. My favorite episode was episode 8.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Last Dance.
Yeah, yeah. Last Dance Barnes. Last Dance Freestyle. YouTube exclusive. Holla at me.
Coming up.
Coming up.
Two million views. Shout out to 6ix9ine.